If you've just started the Hallelujah Diet, no doubt you're excited. I mean, you've lost weight, the physical problems you've had for years are gone, you feel awesome, you want to do this for the rest of your life, but your spouse doesn't want to come with you. What do you do? First of all, don't cause World War III over it. I mean, even when it comes to matters of faith, the Bible says, stick around and be a good influence to the other spouse. It's the same way with the Hallelujah Diet. If your other spouse doesn't want to come along, employ some creativity. How do you do that? Ask Judy Fleming of Hallelujah Acres Canada. When she first started this, her husband and 21-year-old son wanted nothing to do with it. But because she was concerned for their health, she employed some things that were slightly unorthodox.
So what I started with is I started to prepare every single meal the same as I had before, but I introduced something called a large salad at the beginning of every meal. And I did not have the cooked part of the food, which is what we always ate before, in large abundance, was mostly cooked. I didn't have that ready so that they had nothing to choose from except for the raw salad. And of course, they were hungry, so they would eat it.
Sound tricky? Well, maybe a little, but it did get them eating salad. And here's the point. After only a week, eating the salad first was no big deal. Judy's son even joked about it.
And actually, by the end of the first week, my son's comment was, "Dad, we might as well finish the salad because you know she's not going to give us the hot stuff until we finish the salad."
All the while, Judy's diet was completely Hallelujah friendly, but she still served meat to her family. Knowing they weren't ready to give up meat just yet, she bought the best of the best and smaller quantities of it.
What they were used to is each getting a chicken breast or each getting a steak. So what I did is I started buying free-range organic meat to serve to them. And I would buy one piece and cut it up into smaller pieces and put it into a casserole. I would make the casserole so that I could eat it too, and then in another bowl, make the casserole with their meat in it.
By making meals this way, everyone was happy and slowly getting healthier. She also stopped baking sweets and instead bought more fruit to offer as dessert, which worked well. As they began to eat more and more plant-based foods, Judy always made sure there was a break in the action to help her family transition.
One day a week, I allowed them to eat anything they wanted. I told them, okay, Fridays, I'm not responsible for the food. You can do whatever you want. So I always gave them, right from the very beginning, one day a week. And I would say by about the first year, by the end of the first year, that one day a week was no longer anything they wanted. They liked what I was making.
Like Judy said, this was after the first year. Your family may not transition to the Hallelujah Diet overnight either. In fact, it took Judy's family several years. They first gave up meat, but giving up cheese and eggs took longer. However, because she lived what she believed in, eventually the message of a plant-based diet got through, not only to her immediate family, but to others around her.
Maybe not 100%. I would say probably half of my family and friends have changed to be on the Hallelujah Diet, but the other half are leaning towards the Hallelujah Diet more so than they did before because of my change in life, because they could see the difference in me.
So what do you do if your family doesn't see eye to eye on the Hallelujah Diet? Take it from Judy. Be true to yourself, be consistent, and your example will make a difference. For HATV, I'm Scott Laird.